All right, so today I have been waiting for this all week.
Me too, man. Thank you to everybody who commented on our last Angelina Jordan video
We
and
have
educated us.
some real stans, or as they are called, angels.
Angels, that's right.
Now, I can't tell you how many people have requested this next cover that we are about to take in. I put a spell on you. I can't wait.
So first we're going to watch the original Screamin' Jay Hawkins, which I'm not familiar with at all,
No, I don't know who he is.
just to get a reference point. I Put a Spell on You is a 1956 song written and composed by Jalousie Screamin' Jay Hawkins. Okay, so Screamin' Jay Hawkins is the original writer of this song. Let's check it out. Interesting. Oh, you've heard this before, right?
Oh, yeah.
Because of my
I feel some duende coming.
Yeah, I mean, I sense duende
Oh, yeah.
with the whole performance.
Yeah.
Stop the things you do.
What's that show? This little rhythm right here, long, America's Most Wanted.
Bad boys,
yeah,
what
bad,
you want? What you want?
But look, as much as we may not be able to relate with the some aspects of this theatrical performance,
Yeah.
you can feel it. Come on, he's pouring his emotion out in every way. You know,
Yeah, you
he's
can.
shaking the whatever it's
The
called. He's
tambourine.
singing. He's got a prop. It's an entire theatrical performance.
I don't want to say it's dark, but that's the feeling I got.
Oh yeah, I mean, my first thought is death.
Yeah, it's very dark. When he was singing and holding the prop or the skull, it reminded me of a ventriloquist, but his mouth was always moving. But the horns caught me from his. From
His
his
nose.
nose to sort of caught me off, but yeah.
No, I think if we did further research into this song, I think that would enlighten us some more.
Well,
Just
the good thing is we can. So Hawkins had originally intended to record I Put a Spell on You as a refined love song. However, the producer brought in ribs and chicken and got everybody drunk, and we came out with this weird version. I don't even remember making the record. Before, I was just a normal blues singer. I was just Jay Hawkins. It all sort of just fell in place. I found out I could do more destroying a song and screaming it to death.
I found out I could do more destroying a song and screaming it to death. What's that mean?
I don't know. The hit brought Hawkins together with Cleveland disc jockey Alan Freed, who promptly added him to his rock and roll revue. Up to this time, Hawkins had been a blues performer, emotional but not wild. Freed suggested a gimmick to capitalize on the demented sound of I Put a Spell on You. So Hawkins wore a long cape and appeared on stage by rising out of a coffin in midst of smoke and fog. The act was a sensation, later bolstered by tusks, worn in Hawkins' nose. On stage, snakes and fireworks, a cigarette-smoking skull named Henry, okay, and ultimately Hawkins transforming himself into the Black Vincent Price. This theatrical act was one of the first shock rock performances.
Shock rock?
Shock rock.
Interesting.
I mean, you just want to keep clicking on Wikipedia.
Where will we go next?
Shock rock is the combination of rock music and heavy metal music with highly theatrical live performances emphasizing shock value. Okay. I was shocked by seeing that. Back in 19 whatever, I'd be shocked if I saw that on my television.
Performances may include violent or provocative behavior from the artists, the use of attention-grabbing imagery such as costumes, masks, or face paint, or special effects such as pyrotechnics or fake blood. Shock rock also often includes elements of horror. Okay, so maybe we're reading too deep into this, you know, stating that it's duende when it may, you know, be more so, you know, just not just, but more so a theatrical performance of shock rock.
Right. And the bit that he did when he just jumbled out those words, he wasn't speaking English. He wasn't speaking any language, to my knowledge.
Yeah. I mean,
but I think that was part of the performance.
The feeling, you know, when you get when you watch a performance like this is of somebody being possessed, right? I mean, possessed, where he's stating words that don't sound like words. You know, he's getting his emotion out, but it's interesting.
You ever do that? You ever never?
No.
When you just have to get something out and there's no word or anything you could say that would get it out for you?
I don't know. I don't think so.
I think you'd be lying to yourself. I've heard you do that before. Anyway, all right. So what did people say? They said this has to be the one that you listen to next.
Well, they said, what is it, Bohemian Rhapsody.
Okay.
But, I mean, I think more people said I Put a Spell on You.
So. By far more people said I Put a Spell on You. Black and white version.
Yes.
And 9 years old.
I am so excited to watch this. People say that Angelina Jordan arranged this herself. I don't know what that means, but maybe we can search that up really quickly. What does it mean to arrange your own music? Arranging is the art of taking a piece of music and making it your own, or taking a melody and adding different instruments under it, such as a rhythm section or even a full horn section. The arrangement is then the final product of all the instruments coming together during that one piece of music.
Okay, so that makes sense.
Oh, this will be interesting.
So she made it her own, just like it seems like she makes every song her own. And you know what many people said? She not only makes it her own, she does it better.
Oh, yeah. I mean, they've said she has 1,000 voices. Is that what they said?
Yep.
1,000 voices.
1,000 voices. Let's look at some of the comments real quick.
These people are devoted angels.
Oh, yeah.
That's all I have to say. I saw one person, I don't know if it was hounding another person. I think it may have just been helping another angel. They said, when you make recommendations, post links.
Post the link.
Which I, hey.
Yeah. So Danny says, her cover of I Put a Spell on You, 9 years old, in parentheses, is mental. And she actually arranged this song herself at 9 years old. So when they say arrange, that's what they're talking about. The art of taking a piece of music and making it your own.
Okay. And now, does this include all of the instruments as well? Or is it just the act of singing?
We're going to find out. definitely the act of singing.
Absolutely.
But if she's in a studio or with a band or something, we'll find out.
Or if she's playing every instrument by herself.
Can she play instruments too?
Oh, yeah.
They said that?
I believe so.
Oh, my goodness. All right, let's just read a few more comments here.
Let's go to Preben Johansson. She says, black and white version of I Put a Spell on You, age 9, is probably her most spectacular one. Her version of Bohemian Rhapsody on America's Got Talent is maybe the most beautiful Queen cover you will ever hear. You mentioned Adele and Angelina recently did a beautiful cover of Easy on Me. I can't wait
to listen to that one.
But I prefer her version of All I Ask, also quite recent, which is absolutely breathtaking. Wow. Yeah, thank you for all of these recommendations.
Yeah. So Rachel says, it's always a pleasure to watch people discover my favorite musical artist, Angelina Jordan. But to hear you put a name to that unfathomable thing she does to us when she sings, Duende, you just got my subscription. Thank you, Rachel. I'm a poet and have loved Lorca's work for ages. You aptly found the term for AJ's effect on the listener.
A poet?
A poet. In every one of her 160 plus videos, most covers, and many of them covering Adele. Have fun on the journey. Maybe next try her original song, Million Miles. Mm. We might just have to try that next.
Yeah. But I heard she only has like 5 original songs at the moment.
Mm-hmm.
I have a sense that, you know, in a few years, as they say, she will be on the Billboard charts.
Mm.
You know?
Yep.
But I want to hear some of that poetry.
Oh, for sure. Last comment real quick from David. David says, Angelina is known for having 1,000 voices, like you said. She also performs barefoot to remind her of all the less fortunate children in the world. She has helped raise millions for charities. She is the youngest published author in Norway at age 9.
Wow.
My goodness. She wrote the book about an encounter she had with a poor girl weighing people in the streets for money. Angelina and the girl were both around 6 years old. It was in the Middle East and was cold. The girl had scars on her feet. Angelina approached the girl and struck up a conversation. Angelina ended up taking the shoes off her feet and gave them to the girl.
Yeah, so you get a sense here that, you know, Angelina is a very special young talent. And it goes far deeper than just, you know, her musical talent.
Oh, for sure. And that's why they call her the Barefoot Queen of Song, or the Barefoot Princess of Jazz.
Wow. At such a young age to have such a widespread impact.
Yeah.
Very few people can do that.
Yeah, she has an army behind her, man. Yeah. Wow.
And I've literally only seen one 2-minute performance of her.
Yeah.
You know, I'm excited for this one.
All right, let's get into it, man. They say this one is going to blow our minds. They say it's one of her best. So here we go. Angelina Jordan, I Put a Spell on You. There's Jay Hawkins.
Mm.
Ah.
It's got a band.
Arranged. Is that what they mean by arranged? It's fully arranged.
Which I think she wrote it for them. Fully arranged.
Wrote what? The music?
Yeah, she wrote all the music for them to
play.
The
notes and stuff.
I believe so.
Please let us know if you all know. That's amazing.
Oh boy.
Because you're mine. Stop the things you do. I ain't lying. I can't stand.
to pause.
What?
I have to pause it.
Nine?
No, no, no. All right, I'm trying to put use some words here. It is so intricate.
Yeah.
Like it's something that, again, you really can't explain. You just have to hear it.
Mm.
You know, you don't even, we can't even put to words what all that is going on. You know?
Wow. She's gifted. Yes. She is different. This is not normal. We know that. But it goes beyond just those things. I mean,
they're calling her a once in a century talent. No.
Christina Aguilera is just popping yes. in my head constantly. Yes. Every time Angelina Jordan raises her voice and starts giving her entire soul, her soul is coming out of her mouth. And she's screaming. She's just screaming. And it's never off key, never off pitch. I wish I knew how to dissect vocals.
Yes.
I don't.
You get all of that, right? You get all of that. And then you also get the screaming Jay Hawkins feel.
Mm.
You know, she's amazing at capturing the voices and the feelings that other artists exhibit.
She studies.
She studies.
And then embodies.
Yes.
She studies and then embodies, Jared, and then shares.
Yes.
Like that's why they say she's has 1,000 voices, I think, because she lets different spirits run through her.
Yeah.
At 9 years old, you're not supposed to be able to command the presence that she commands like this. Just yes. standing there with a full band.
Yes.
Behind you.
I get the sense that she is 150% devoted to the art, the craft of singing and music. You know, whereas other 9-year-olds today are glued to their smartphones. This young girl, I feel, you know, is entirely devoted to making music.
But let's just think about that, Jared. 9 years old. 9 years old.
And she's 16 today, right?
She's 16 today, but 9 years old. You would never, ever, ever guess she's 9 years old.
Yeah.
If you were closing your eyes and listening to her sing.
You may even guess that she's from the 1940s.
She's like a chameleon.
Yeah.
She can blend in any era, any song. And this is only our second song that we've heard from her.
And I know there is a conversation out there of, is she appropriating, you know, the work of other artists?
Appropriating.
Yeah. Like, you know, I don't see it that way.
I mean, we listened to the original Screamin' Jay Hawkins.
Yes.
Let's go back to the beginning here, because she lifted up, I think it was a mug with Screamin' Jay Hawkins on it. Let's play that real quick. Hold on. Let me see.
It's in the very beginning.
Oh, there we go. Yep. So it's a candle. It's a candle with Screamin' Jay Hawkins on it. I don't know if somebody made her aware of Screamin' Jay Hawkins or if she sought him out. But this right here lets you know that she's only paying respect. She's got his spirit in the room. She's burning a candle with his face on it. This is in black and white. You know, like all of these things are choices out of respect.
Yes.
To embody another individual out of respect. That's mind-blowing, Jared.
I'm interested to learn more about this whole arrangement thing. You know, whether she actually composed, you know, her interpolation or whatever of the music that the people in the room were playing.
Yeah.
In addition to her, you know, vocals. You know, then it's the entire package.
You know how people, I don't know if anybody has said it in the comments, but a lot of times when you are first put on to an artist or a song, you try to stay away from people's critiques of it or people's commentary about it because you want to develop your own, right? But with Angelina Jordan, the way that she covers songs, and now, you know, we learn that she arranges songs, I think it's important to look back on the original creator before you listen to Angelina Jordan, because even this image would have me so lost. Even the black and white would have me so lost.
Exactly.
Even the screaming, how she is performing would have me so lost if I didn't have a reference point.
And if we didn't have a reference point, again, the first thing that our minds would go to is, oh, this little girl, girl who appears to be white is potentially appropriating the music of a previous generation of people who may have not had the rights that she has. You know?
But it you never get that feel. I haven't gotten that feeling yet. Yeah. What was the previous song that she covered?
I'd Rather Go Blind.
I'd Rather Go Blind. Etta James, another black woman.
Yes.
Right? I mean, how many 9-year-old kids are singing songs from the 1900s, mid-1900s, from black men and women?
Yeah.
I mean, that's just a side point, but it doesn't really matter at the end of the day.
No, I just, you know, I get the feeling of her respecting the craft and respecting artists that came before her.
Yeah.
But also the feeling of, again, you know, out of respect, I'm going to take your song to the next level. Right? And I'm going to try to do my best to perfect the arrangement and the delivery of my version of your song.
In the voice.
In the voice, exactly. I want to get as close to replicating your voice as I can.
In the spirit.
Exactly. It's the whole package.
Wow.
Now, I'm excited to listen to some of, you know, the more contemporary artists.
Yeah.
Adele in particular.
Oh, yeah. We really, really appreciate everybody who educated us on Angelina Jordan and her background and let us hear. Because you guys really led us to listen to this song.
Yeah.
We have a few different ones that we've already pinpointed that we want to listen to next that you all have brought to us. But please, anything we said in this video, if we are incorrect about anything, please let us know and educate us on how you felt when you watched this and your take on it. Leave a like, leave a comment, but most importantly, make sure you subscribe, because we are on the Angelina Jordan journey. And I think I'll consider myself an angel now.
Yeah.
I mean, she's amazing. There's no doubt about it. There's no doubt about it.
Yeah.
So we appreciate you guys. Peace.
Peace.